Brands use Klout to reach out to the influencers for word of mouth marketing. For example, Audi has this test drive campaign that they offered to influencers in San Francisco. They basically invite all those opinion leaders in different vectors of the industry to come in and test drive one of this newest model and get a sense of how they feel about this new model. That's what Audi do. And Virgin America, for example, offer this VIP service for those who are even just a Klout user. When they come to the airport terminal, they invite those influencers over to their VIP lounge just for all the perks that they have there. Because you know they think having a Klout score is a good indicator of you being influential and savvy with this social media thing that's coming up. So and people have different ways of using Klout scores across different domains. I've also heard of some dating sites using Klout score as a signal to match people up.
Cool. Any other ways that you can think of off the top of your head?
Some CMOs, chief marketing officers, use Klout to just filter their candidates with, because you know a lot of the big, more traditional companies, when they're trying to adapt to the social media era, they try to hire someone with social media background to be able to help with their branding and picture of the company. And for those jobs, having a Klout score is a must, I've heard. I think Barack Obama, the president, has the highest Klout score of 99. And San Francisco Giants, interestingly, after they won the World Series, they had a share that same score for a month.
Wow. And Justin Bieber?
Justin Bieber has a very high Klout score of 92. And a lot of celebrities and media celebrities are within that range, but he's definitely one of the highest Klout score.